Hello friends, in this session we are going to discuss about creating a logical standby database. So first, what is the benefits of implementing the logical standby database? So here the provides an efficient use of the system resources, means open, independent and active production database. So this database, once you configure this database will be in the read write mode, means it is an active production database, open and independent. Additional indexes and the materialized view can be created for the improve the query performance. Fine, so additional index if you want to create on the logical standby, or any of the materialized view if you want to create on the logical standby to improve the performance, you can create it. Reduce the workload on the primary database by offloading the following workloads to the logical standby database. Means you can just offload some work from primary to logical standby. So here for the reporting purpose, for the submissions, for the queries. Means if you want to use this logical standby for the reporting or any kind of query execution, for that purposes you can use this logical standby database. Provides the data protection, means primary database corruption not propagated. Means if any corruptions are there on the primary, that is not going to be propagated on your logical standby database. Provides the disaster recovery capability, means switch over and the failover you can perform from the primary to logical standby, logical standby to primary. Okay, minimize the downtime for the planned and unplanned outage. Also can be used for the upgrade the database software and apply the patch set. So if you want to upgrade or any kind of patching you want to do, so that for that activity you can also use this logical standby database. Next, architecture. So here this is the your production database, that is your primary database, this is the your logical standby database. So here what happened, whatever the redos are there, that redo is transferring to the your logical standby database. Now on logical standby database, redos are converting into the SQL statements, and that SQL statements are executed on your logical standby. Okay, so this is the, here you have a SQL apply process, this is the your redo transfer process, and once the redo is transferring to the your standby database, after that it transforms the redo information into the SQL. Fine, and SQL apply process that execute this statements, SQL statement to the your logical standby database, and this database you can use for the reporting purpose. So this is called as a your logical standby database. So this is the architecture that is called as a your SQL apply architecture. Next, preparing to create a logical standby database. So first is, perform the following steps on the primary database before creating the logical standby database. So these steps you need to perform initially on the primary database. Checks for the unsupported data type. See, in the logical standby database, it is not a block to block, it is the executing the SQL statement. So here some of the data types, some of the tables are not with the, some different data types are not supported in your logical standby. So here the first for the unsupported data types. Beware of the unsupported DDL commands. So few of the DDL commands are also not going to be executed on your logical standby. Ensure the row uniqueness. Fine, so row uniqueness should be there. Duplicate data should not be there on the primary, so that is not going to be applied onto your logical standby. Verify that the primary database is configured with the archive log mode. Fine, so your primary database should be always be in the archive log mode. So before preparing, before creating the logical standby, you need to just prepare few of the things. This is the things you need to keep in your mind. So let's see in the detail. First is the unsupported object. So log apply service automatically excludes the unsupported object when applying the redo data to the logical standby database. So few of the objects are unsupported, so that is going to be not applied, this is not going to be not applied, it is excluded whenever the it is applying to the logical standby database automatically. So this is the unsupported objects, tables and the sequences in the C schema. So whatever the tables and the sequences are there in the C schema, that is not going to be applied to the your logical standby. Tables used to support the materialized view, global temporary tables and tables with the unsupported data. So these are the things are not supported in your logical standby database. Next, unsupported data types. So here log apply service automatically exclude the tables with the unsupported data types when apply redo to the logical standby database. So here unsupported data types, that is the B file row ID and the U row ID. So these are, these data types are not supported in the logical standby database. Okay, in the primary is there, fine, but whenever it is applying to the logical standby, it is not going to be applied and it is exclude the that specific tables. Fine, user defined data types, multimedia data types like spatial, image, oracle, text, this is not supported on the logical standby. Collections, vArray and the nested tables. XML type stored as an object relation, so this is also not supported in the logical standby. Binary XML, this is all are not supported in the logical standby environment. Checking for the unsupported tables, like which are the tables are unsupported, if you want to check, how can you check? So query the DBA logical standby underscore unsupported table. This is the table. You from this table you can just identify like these are the tables are not supported in my environment. Fine. So you can just query these things onto your primary and you can just find out these are the tables are unsupported on the my logical standby. Fine. So here select star from DBA logical standby unsupported tables order by owner. So you can just find out from the here. Next. Checking for the tables with the unsupported data types, fine. So here table name, column name, attribute, data type from DBA logical standby unsupported where the owner equal to. So I am just giving the one example if owner is OE or Scott. So in that schema, you can just check it out table name, column name, attributes, data types from the DBA logical standby underscore unsupported where owner equal to OE. So that you can just execute this query and you can just identify like these are the tables are unsupported on the my logical standby environment. Next, that is the SQL command that do not execute on the logical standby database. So few of the your commands are there which is not going to be executed on the your logical standby. That is the explain command, lock table, set constraint, set role, set transactions, alter database, alter sessions, alter materialized view log, alter system, create control file, create database link. So these are the commands which are not executed on the logical standby. Next, fine. So here this is also few commands, create p file from sp file, create schema authorization, create materialized view, create the materialized view log, create a sp file from p file, drop the database link, that drop the materialized view, drop the materialized view log. So these are the also the commands which are not going to be executed on your logical standby. Okay, this is the unsupported PLSQL supplied package. So these are the packages, PLSQL packages, which are also not supported in your logical standby environment. So this is the DBMS Java, DBMS registry, DBMS alert, space admin, refresh, DBMS redefinition, and DBMS AQ. So these are the also the PLSQL objects which are not supported in the logical standby. Next. Ensuring the row uniqueness. Fine. So duplicates rows, if you have a duplicates rows on the primary database table, so that is also not going to be executed on your logical standby. So here query the DBA logical standby not unique on the primary database to find out the tables without unique identifier, means without the unique index, without the unique constraint or the without the primary key. So you can just find it out from the here, select star from DBA logical standby not unique. So it will just give you the list of tables with the without the primary key or the unique key. So add the primary key or unique key, unique index to ensure that the SQL can efficiently apply the data updates. Fine. So here you need to just find out select owner, table name, bat column from the DBA logical standby not unique, where table name not in, select table name from the DBA logical standby unsupported. Because unsupported, we can remove it. Which is not going to unsupported, that table we don't require. Other than this, the tables which are supported but the uniqueness are not there. Fine. So you can just find it out the tables. You can just create the unique constraint or the primary key on these tables, and that table is going to be update your database to the your logical standby. Next, creating the logical standby using the SQL commands. So here once you check everything, unsupported data types, unsupported tables, row uniqueness, everything, once you're done, next task is to the implementing. So to create the logical standby database using the SQL command, these are the steps. So create the physical standby database, so that we already have. Stop, redo, apply on the primary, fine, on the physical standby database. So what you can do, you can just stop applying the your redo information from primary to standby. Next, prepare the primary database to support the logical standby database. So you need to first prepare the primary database. Next, build the log miner directory in the Rudy data. Fine. You need to just build the log miner directory, transitions to the logical standby database, open the logical standby database and verify that the logical standby database is performing the properly. So these are the steps which you need to perform on using the SQL command on primary as well as on your logical standby database. So let's see practically how to do all these things.
So here, first of all, we are going to discussing about the SQL apply architecture in detail. So here, this is a redo data from your primary database, fine. So this is going to be one reader process is there on the logical standby database that will read the data. That redo record is transferring to the preparer process that will prepare the, your data. And here this is the LCR which is in the shared pool. So here logical change records not group into the transactions. So this is going to be make it into the group by the builder process. Fine, this is the one builder process is there. Also the one analyzer process you have, which analyzer process will do transaction sorted in the dependency order. Fine, so this is also going to be done by the analyzer process. And one coordinator process is there, that is coordinator is sending this data to the applier process, transactions to be applied, which are the transactions to be applied, that is going to be sent by the applier process, and this applier process will apply the data to the your data file. So this is the actual process is called, first this is process is called as a log mining, that is reader will read the data, preparer will prepare the data, and builder will build the data. And this is the process, applying process, this is the analyzing coordinator and the applier process, this is called as a your applying process. Fine, so this is the your detailed architecture of your logical standby database. So here preparing to the create a logical standby database, first you need to do the preparation. So what is the first thing you need to do? Check for the unsupported table. So query the DBA logical standby underscore unsupported table on the primary database for the unsupported table. So here you can just execute this first SQL statement. So you will get the list of the unsupported table on the primary database. So let me execute these things on the primary database. First of all, SQL plus. So no row selected, fine, no tables are unsupported, each and every tables are supported. Next, checking the table with the unsupported data type, fine. So how can you check it out? DBA logical standby unsupported on the primary database for the table with the unsupported data types, select. So here you can just check it out. This is I am taking from the OE user, or you can also take from the Scott user or any of the user, fine, or also you can just execute. So here no row selected, fine. If you want to just find out for the any of the specific user, you can also find out. So unsupported data types are, nothing is there, everything is supported. Enqueue the unique row identifier, means all the rows, all the tables having the primary key, unique key, no duplicate data, that you need to just check it out by using this SQL statement. There is a DBA logical standby not unique on the primary database to find out the tables without a unique identifier. So this you need to also execute on the primary. So this is first of all that we are just doing the all the preparation. So this is a Scott. So DBA logical standby not unique, bonus and the salary, these are two tables you have which is containing the your not containing any kind of primary key or the unique uniqueness is not creating, fine. So add the primary key or unique index to ensure that SQL apply can efficiently apply the data updates. So here what we can do, just check this table DESC bonus, fine, connect to the fine DSC bonus, fine. What you can do, employee name, job, salary, commission. So alter table bonus, add constraint ename not null. So here alter table bonus, add constraint name bonus unique, fine. This is the constant name I am giving, and the unique, and in that I am just defining your all the column names which you want to add. So I am just defining the like e name, that is the as my unique constraint, fine. Different, the second table is your cell grade, DESC cell grade. So grade I am just giving alter table grade, add constraint grade underscore unique grade, fine. This is the two things we have added. Now just check anything else is remaining. two unique constants you have added. Connect with the sys as a sysdba. So still it is showing. So here, fine. So this is fine. So here I have added the constraint. So not an issue with that unique constraint I have added. So data duplication is not going to be there. Fine. So not an issue with this. And here you can also just check the tables which are unsupported other than this, anything else. So here you'll find the two things. This is the two tables, but we have added the unique constraint. So not an issue with that. Now just check the database in the archive log mode or not. So here archive log list. Yeah, this is the archive log mode. Okay. Create the logical standby database by using the SQL command. So let's see now creation of the logical standby. Before that, we have just do the all the prerequisite task. Okay. To create the logical standby database, what you need to do? Create the physical standby. So here, first step is to create the physical standby database. Physical standby database is already created. In our case, fine, we already created physical standby database and they both are in the synchronization. So I'm just showing you the synchronization. Fine. So here both are synchronizing properly. We need to check first. So here RFS is everything is going fine. Next, what do you require? Your database in the archive log mode, physical standby database is already there. What do you require? Stop the redo apply on the primary database. Fine. Before converting physical standby database to logical standby database, stop the redo apply. So what you can do? You can just alter database, recover, manage, standby, cancel. So here you are just canceling the recovery. Fine. Next, prepare the primary database to support the logical standby database. So here you need to just set up the logical log archive destination and initialization parameter for transitions to a logical standby role. So here this everything is set up during our physical standby database. Location we are using the same valid for online log files, primary role. This is also same DB unique name, that is standby, and DB log archive destination stat n equal to enable. So here you can just see show parameter log archive dash state 2. Fine. So this is enabled. Show parameter. Fine. So here the second parameter you can just check. Fine. This is the parameter is set. Fine. So here no need to worry about anything. The parameter is already set up and it is also enabled. Also set the undo retention to 3600. So fine. If you keep this 900 or 1800, that is also fine. So no issues with the undo retention. Fine. In case if you want to change, you can, if you want to keep the more undo data, you can keep it over here. Next is a build a log miner directory into redo data. So build a log miner directory in the redo data so that the SQL apply can properly interpret the changes in the redo. So you need to build the log miner. Supplement the logging is automatically enabled. Execute the procedure on the primary database. So this is you need to execute on your primary database. Fine. So just build this thing. So execute this statement. Fine. After that, what you need to do? Transitions to the logical standby database. So execute the following commands on the your standby database to convert it to the logical standby database. So alter database, recover to logical standby, standby. So here what you can do, this is I am going to convert alter database, recover to logical standby, standby. Fine. So this is we are converting your physical standby database to the logical standby database. This is database is altered. Fine. Shut down the logical standby database instance and restart in the mount mode. So let's see. Shutdown immediate. This activity you need to do on the standby. Don't shut down primary. It is not required. And mount it. Fine. And after mounting is done, adjust the initialization parameter. So this all this parameter is already set up during the physical data guard environment. If it is not set up, then you need to set up. Fine. open the logical standby database. So open the new logical standby database with the reset log option. So here you can open the database with the reset log option. Fine, and start application of the redo data to the logical standby database immediately. So alter database, start logical standby, apply immediate. This is going to be start applying the data from your primary to logical standby database. This is the conversion is done. Fine, and this is the starting of the your information, starting of your transferring the redo information. Fine, so this is done. What do you require the next? Alter database, start logical standby, apply immediate. So it will start applying and verify that the logical standby database is performing properly. Fine. So these things you need to just identify whether the everything is working fine or not. Once you just start recovery process. So this is the altered. So this is the, your database is now converted to the logical standby database. Just verify. So no row selected because this will take some time. You can just execute on the primary. Fine, so this is the all your directory. Fine, first time, next time. Fine, and here it will take some time. Okay, so begin sending redo data to the standby database. So here what you can do, alter system archive log current. So just execute this statement on the primary. Just start sending the data. Fine. And after that, you can just execute this statement. Fine. So you can just see the sequence number 95, 96, 97 are going to be registering to the your standby database. Fine. So this is going to be registering. Now, query the DBA logical standby log to view the verify that the archive redo log files were registered. Fine. Verify. This is the same query. You need to just executing again. Initially nothing was there, but once you start sending the data, it will registering. Verify that the redo data is being applied currently. So here you can just check, select name comma value from V dollar logical standby states where name equal to coordinator state. So here you can just check different processes. So here you can see coordinator state, it is a initializing. Fine, it is a initializing. So it is going on at this moment. So it will take time. It is initializing. Fine. Next is query the v$log standby process view to see the current SQL apply activity. So here you can just see the current SQL apply activity. Fine. So this is the your activity is going on. So here you can see these are the all the architecture what we have seen initially, that is the all the types: coordinator, reader, builder, preparer. These are the all these things. Fine. Coordinator, reader, builder, preparer. These are all the your processes, logical standby processes. So these are all the processes are going on at this moment. So everything is working fine, but synchronization will take some time because we have just started. So here you can just check the applied SCN and the latest SCN which you receive on the logical standby. So here you can just check this thing. So here you can see the latest SCN which you receive, that is a 1561598 applied 1561596. It is just you can see this thing, it is going on, this process is going on. Fine. So in this way you can just convert your physical standby database to the your logical standby database. These are very easy steps. Once you configure the physical standby database, after that, and once you set up all the parameter, only thing is you required to execute this dbms underscore logical standby dot build, then convert to the logical standby and open the logical standby with the reset log and start applying recovery. Fine. So alter database, start logical standby, apply immediate. These are the only steps you require to convert physical standby to logical standby. So in this session we have discussed about the creation of the logical standby database.